step into a new realm. Welcome to Realms of Healing with your host, Akashic Intuitive, Gabriel Llewellyn-Ari.
Hello, and welcome to Realms of Healing. My name is Gabriel Llewellyn-Ari, and it is my privilege and honor to be with you this next hour here on Realms of Healing. We have such an exciting and wonderful show today. I'm so excited to be sharing with you a dear, dear friend of mine. His name is Rob Stuart, and he is the creator of something called the 40-Day Activation, which he's going to be telling us all about. He also is a yoga therapist, a health activist, and a natural food educator, and has a channel on YouTube. Rob Stuart, welcome to the show.
Hi, thank you very much for having me. Very excited to be here.
Oh, yes, yes, absolutely. So, Rob, let's just go straight for the gold here.
Let's do it.
What is the 40-day activation?
The 40-day activation is, it's really interesting. It's a cleanse. It's a period of adjustment. It's a period of growth. It's a diet. It's an exercise program, and it's also none of those things. It's a culmination of the things I've learned to make myself healthy, condensed and put into a 40-day basic schedule, and has basic rules and basic meditations to follow every day to help you cleanse. And the basics of it is, it's all natural foods. It's to alkalize your body, to clean your mind, and to rejuvenate your soul. And it's happens in 40 days straight up, because that's biblical. The Buddha, Jesus, Muhammad, you know, you can go down the list. All the enlightened beings did some crazy transitional meditation, cleanse, ritual, if you will, for 40 days. So that's why I named it the 40-day activation.
Got it. So what was your inspiration for creating this and for starting this for other people to be a part of?
I wanted to, my background is so holistic. It's part Ayurvedic, it's part macrobiotic, it's part like yogic, old school hatha yogic. I dabble with some knowledge from Chinese medicine. And so it's like a total hodgepodge. And what I found was like all these overlapping themes within all of them. Like all of them had things that were like, okay, this is bad, this is okay, but this works really good. And all the things, all the different styles, the yogic, the Ayurvedic, the macrobiotic, the low-fat vegan, they all pointed to three things that were true in every single diet that worked. That's fruits, vegetables, and whole grains. It's impossible to go wrong with those things. Impossible. Like your body cannot reject those things. Those are the natural staples of the whole body of the world. With that said, if you consume all of your calories from those things, or mostly from those things, you're not taking any chance with your health. Like, I will never say that milk is bad or that meat is bad, but you have to say, if I do this, then this could happen. So if you eat meat, your body will be more acidic for sure. Is it good for you or bad for you? I don't know. That's for you to decide. And then there's things like ghee, and there's things like superfoods that are what I call like the gray area. Like, these could be good for me. I feel good on them, but are they really? I don't know. There's no long-term tests, so they could be really good, but I'm not sure. This diet and this program is based on what we know. 100% we know that fruits and vegetables and whole grains do nothing but make you healthy. So that's where the food comes from. And then the other side of it is all yogic, and from my athletic background and from my love of dance and improv and play. And
I have to say, so just so everyone knows, I've been doing this 40-day activation,
right,
for, gosh,
24 days?
A little bit less than that, because I started a little bit later. Right. I restarted.
Uh-huh.
But
restart.
Yeah, but for almost 20 days. And that was actually one of the things that really drew me into doing it was that you were very committed to having fun, and exercising in a way that you love. And I thought, of course. I mean, that's something that I've done, I think, subconsciously, but I hadn't really made an effort to do that. And to really think about it, I was, you know, I have a moon in Virgo, so very much like, okay, got to do this, got to do that, got to do all this, yeah. You know, getting very analytical about everything. Right. And it was really wonderful to just let it go and just say, what do I love to do? Well, I love to dance, I love to jog, and I love to punch things. So that's all I do for my workouts.
That's all you need. Mm-hmm. And like, I talk about food all the time because I don't want to think about food. You know what I mean?
Ah.
Like food, like the whole book is about food, and the amount of time I spend preparing food and thinking about food compared to most Americans is like way, way, way less. Because I don't want to. I don't want to spend my life thinking about what I can and cannot eat and what I should eat and what maybe. I don't want it to be like that. I want to be like, oh, I'm hungry, refuel, go play. I'm hungry, okay, refuel, and then go play more. Oh, I'm hungry, refuel, and then sleep. Like, that's what I want my day to be like. And how that leads to the play, into the athletics, into the fun, is like, if you're going to stress yourself out and be like, I have to hit the gym 4 times this week. And you could do that, and your head's telling you that it wants to do that. And you force yourself to do it, and like, you start to see some gains, or maybe you get 1 week in and it's just like too hard. Mm-hmm. It's like, then you quit everything.
Yeah,
and you go back to just chilling out, Facebooking it for hours, watching Netflix, and it's like, and you get all down on yourself, like, I can't keep up a fitness program. It's like, well, no one can keep up anything. We're human beings, like we're not meant to really like be forced into doing these really monotonous alignment things. So might as well find what you naturally like. Like, if you like to walk, bad, awesome, walk your butt off. Literally, walk your butt off. Do it every day. Do it all the time. Put your headphones on. Take your headphones off. If you like doing laundry, like literally go to the laundromat and volunteer and hoist laundry into things. For like,
it's a workout. Laundry is a workout.
Or garden. Anything you have passion for, do it, because that's all you'll ever be consistently doing. You know what I mean? It's all about what can you do that you'll consistently want to keep doing.
It's kind of like the age-old adage, you know, do what you love and you'll never have to work a day in your life. If you bring that into exercise, gosh, what a whole new world that is.
Exactly. And people think of exercise, we're so brainwashed because of magazines and because of marketing and just media in general, Western media, non-conscious Western media, is that fit means huge biceps, rippling, huge chest, and girls with fake boobs and ginormous round butts with tiny waists and muscular, you know, it's like, that's actually not even healthy. And if you look at bodybuilding communities long term, when they hit 30, their faces look like they're 70 and they're bald and their bodies are huge and buff and juicy and look like teens on steroids, but their faces and their organs are destroyed. And it's like, what is your goal? You know what I mean? What are you going for, health, or are you going for like pure vanity? A little vanity is great, I think. Like wanting to be beautiful, wanting to be at your optimum in health and looking good, I think that's natural. But when you take it into that other category of like, I need to do this to get this, then you're missing the whole boat, I think.
Right. When you're sacrificing your health.
Right.
In order to be temporarily beautiful for a little bit.
Or what people will rationalize into thinking is healthy. What society just accepts as being healthy. Like, I had some friends recently kind of like really stoked come up to me and they're like, hey, Rob, we want to get your opinion. We've been doing this super healthy thing every morning. And, you know, we wanted to see how you feel about it. And just, you know, you can be totally straight up honest with us because we just want to know how you feel. So I was like, okay. So that let me be just like non-PC with them and kind of give them the download from my heart. And they're like, we've been doing whey protein, you know, 30 grams of whey protein every morning in this big shake. And we're like, feel so energetic and so good. And I'm just like, it's one of the worst things you could possibly do to your entire body. It confuses your whole system. It wears out your nervous system. It starts to build – new protein receptors that don't understand what real protein is, like plant protein and protein from minerals and greens. It's like it really, 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 really messes you up. And in general, society thinks, oh, whey protein, you know, it's a great protein source. Just, you know, throw it on some milk or throw it in some cereal and just get some extra protein. It's like, man, get some extra cancer, really.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely, absolutely. So back to the 40-day activation. Describe the diet that you have outlined for this program. Like the,
right.
Or what does a day in the life of someone doing the 40-day challenge look like?
All right. First, I'll kind of hit the diet. The diet is based on basically two general rules, actually kind of three. One is alkalizing. The food's got to be alkalizing, because for this 40-day activation, most people who are going to want to do this, and most people in general, even if you've been ultra healthy, you can always alkalize your body. And most people are acidic. Most people are acidic. So all the food's alkalizing. Almost all the food is alkalizing. Even people will say, well, fruit is acidic and it will raise your pH acidity levels. I say, no, fruit has acidity in it, the proper amount of acidity that actually balances the acidity in your body. So therefore it's actually pH balancing. So that argument of that fruit is full of acid and will make your acid levels go up, I'll show you my blood test that I did 2 weeks ago after only eating fruit, and that's it, no greens for 2 weeks. And I was pH balanced and completely alkalized.
Oh, wow.
As you can possibly be.
Wow.
I was in the light blue, which is like four shades up from being too alkalized. And I was eating like basically pineapple, oranges, and bananas. That's it. 14 days. Put it to the test. You know what I mean? Like, so anyway, back to your question. It's alkalizing. The 40-day diet, if you will, is all alkalizing foods, or as alkalizing of diet as you possibly can have. The food has to be very easy to digest, and the food has to be nutrient dense. Those are like the three things. And you can kind of overlap or correspond alkalizing with cleansing to me. So it's got to be cleansing, alkalizing, really easy to digest, really easy to digest. And it's got to be nutrient dense. So the basic diet is you can eat as much fruit as you want. Like literally you can eat as much fruit as you want. And some people say, okay, cool. Then that means for breakfast I can have like an orange and an apple, and then maybe later, you know, snack on a banana. And you could do that, but the better way to do it is by eating what's called mono meals. And mono meals are when you sit down and you pick out on one piece of fruit at a time. So basically, like, for example, today is not a great example, but usually for me, I'm a banana guy. I'm a banana freak. So breakfast for me is usually in between 9 and 20 bananas for breakfast for me, depending on what my day is, depending on what type of exercise or type of routine I'm going to do. So 9 to 20 bananas for me for breakfast. I know people that do whole watermelons, do cantaloupes, apples, oranges. You do whatever. So you can eat as much fruit as you want, and you try to eat them in mono meals. You can also drink as many juices as you want, like juices from a juicer or really nice juices that you buy somewhere. I don't recommend buying them off the shelf. Juicing is by far the best thing you can possibly do. But if you have to get juice, and the only way you can get it is to go to, you know, Whole Foods and buy Evolution or something like that, then that's better than nothing. It's better than not doing it.
I already know what some people are thinking, because I thought this before starting this challenge was, gosh, you know, I was raised with, or not, maybe not raised, but I was brought up with a lot of health knowledge, like, oh, eat very little fruit. Like, fruit is good, but if you eat too much, you can, you know, spike your blood sugar and candida and rot your teeth and all this stuff. And even for me, when I would eat fruit, I felt awful because I would eat it after my meal. I didn't know anything about food combining. I wasn't watching my fat at all. And so, of course, I felt disgusting when I ate fruit.
Right.
So, can you address that? The average American person out there who is who is eating the that is the standard American diet or some form of it.
What I get most of the time is, if I eat that much fruit, I will get a stomachache. And I say, yes, you will. It's also when you have a really, really tight ball in your calf or in your hamstring. Mm. You have to push on it to work it out. Mm. It hurts. Mm. It's called detoxing. Mm. That's a very typical thing for people to eat fruit and feel sick, because it's their body is actually cleansing, a miniature cleanse, and it doesn't feel that good. It's you have a huge mucous membrane in your stomach that's from acidity. It's from all the processed foods. It's mostly from dairy and meat. If we're going to be totally real, it's basically from dairy, meat, and processed food. Mm-hmm. And it sits in your stomach, and when that thing starts to get taken down by fruit, it kind of hurts. But that thing's not supposed to be there. And when that thing's gone and cleansed, and or even just less, you eat the fruit, and the fruit doesn't do the same thing at all when you don't have 75% of your calories coming from fat or huge imbalance with acidity in your body. The other huge problem that people have with fruit, and when they say, I get a stomach ache, is they don't chew it enough. Mm. If you're a person that can't chew your fruit, then blend it. Blend it a lot. You need to blend and chew your fruit till it's the key. What I've learned from my mentors is that you chew something until it caramelizes, until it gets warm and sugary. That means that the glucose is released and ready to be digested. So if you chew everything, you chew your drinks, you chew your shakes, you chew your, you know, like literally my green shakes, I chew my green shakes because they'll change. They'll get warm, sweet, and then that's when they're ready to digest. And another issue with new fruit eaters is that they don't eat ripe fruit. It seems simple. The two simplest things are you don't chew enough and you're picking wrong fruit. And people think ripe fruit is ripe when it's really not ripe. Like people will eat bananas that have like any green on a banana means it's not ripe, period. You know what I mean? Like
right.
Just period. It's not ripe. Doesn't mean you have to have a banana, but when you open it, it's brown and bruised and nasty, but the outside there's freckles. It's not the bruises that make it ripe. It's the freckles. There's little dots that look like brown freckles. And when the banana is fully freckled and dark freckles, that's when you can smell it. It smells sweet, you know, and the peel just comes right off. If you have to like tug the peel to open it, that's a good sign. It's not fresh. Other things that people try to do with fruit, like you said, combining, you know, if you eat pineapple with strawberries and banana and blueberries, which is a very typical thing, you have like four different varieties of fruit, all different acidities that do different things in the body, all combined into one thing, and it's very confusing to the stomach.
Well, and even I know just like the standard American diet, you know, they'll have like fruit salad with their meal, with their steak, and just like, you know, all this stuff, which fruit really should be just eaten by itself.
Right, or like fruit on pizza.
Right, pineapple.
It's good. Don't get me wrong, that stuff tastes amazing. I love it. It tastes good in my mouth, but like I don't like what it does to me, you know?
Yeah. And I already know what a bunch of people are thinking. They're probably thinking like, well, why are we eating so much fruit? And and I, for one, I always told myself like, I will never be a fruitarian. Like that is just messed up. Mm-hmm. And here I find myself now eating mostly fruit. And I we had a copy of the book, the 80-10-10 diet, here at my house. Mm-hmm. And for the longest time I just looked at the cover of that book. Like, what is that about? It's probably like eating 80% something ridiculous. And I finally opened it up. And I was blown away. In fact, that's one of the best health books I think I've ever read. Mm-hmm. I was blown away because Dr. Graham talks all about like what we're supposed to eat and really gives a very compelling or some very compelling evidence about what humans are really designed to eat. Like, are we omnivores? And he talks all about that. Mm-hmm. Dairy, you know, grains, legumes, everything. And it basically comes down to, I'm sure you're going to talk about this, is that we're frugivores. We're meant to eat fruit. We have teeth designed for that. There's a whole other plethora of things in his book that he really talks about why we're meant to eat fruit. Mm-hmm. And so was that some of your inspiration for this program or talk about that?
Interestingly enough, like the opposite.
Really?
I Dr. Graham is like one of my most favorite, and I look up to him, and 80-10-10 spawned my, like, okay, fruit is cool. Like, it allowed me to go with the hunch that I was already on, and it made me feel like, okay, here's a doctor who wrote this book, and it's like, this is what I've already been doing, so okay, it is. It was another scientific prod that was like, okay, you are doing the right thing. But I don't care what we are meant to do. I don't care what we were as cavemen. This is not then. This is an evolved, we're an evolved species. And it's like, this is an evolved diet. And what I really believe is what I kind of said at the beginning of the show is that, like, there is no risk to it. There is no, I'm not sure. You know what I mean? It's no theory. It's only known fact that fruits work. Vegetables work. Whole grains work. So that's all I use. Uh-huh. There's no leaving it up to anything ethereal, anything that's philosophical. It's not even scientific. It's just pure, down-to-earth, minimal, raw. Oh, okay, that makes sense.
Yeah, if it works, do it.
Right.
Basically.
And if every single lineage of science that's ever been known to man agrees on just those things, then you have your science for the people that need the science. There's your whole science. Even the FDA, the only thing that the FDA agrees upon with its European counterpart and the worldwide counterpart is that fruits and vegetables and whole grains are the best things and you should eat more of them every day.
That's been one thing that I've really found so true for myself on this challenge is that I'm surprised at how little I feel I eat, I guess you could say.
Mm-hmm.
And one of my newest things is I wake up in the morning and I just have juice.
Mm-hmm.
Like
right.
Just juice, like a ton of juice. I have all my juice for breakfast.
Mm-hmm.
And then I don't eat, and I don't really eat something until maybe like 2 or 3.
Yeah.
And like today it was a green smoothie and that felt so good after the juice. I might just do that for lunch.
Once your body gets on the flow of it, that's really crazy. Like what the body actually needs and wants. It's really basic. The way you look at it is that you need in life vitamins and minerals.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, and the best source of vitamins and minerals, fruits are pure vitamins that absorb into your body like no other, like bam, in your bloodstream. And if you have any type of metabolism, like I have really fast heat, I'm a total pitta. If you know anything about Ayurveda, I'm pitta ball. My metabolism is crazy, so I eat fruit and metabolize it so fast that it like geeks me out, like Adderall. You know what I mean? It's like like seriously, if kids have ADD and they need Adderall, stop giving them Adderall. Give them like a pineapple, watermelon, orange juice every morning, like 30 ounces of it, and they'll be freaking like Einstein. So they'll be like so buzzed out that they won't even need their Adderall.
It is. I just wanted to say that the morning juice that I have, it's like coffee. It's better. It's better than coffee. It's like I get so energized. I can think super clear. It's incredible.
Right.
I couldn't believe that just by having juice in the morning.
Because think of the science of it.
That.
What coffee is an artificial stimulant.
Mm.
So it takes the place of your body stimulating itself. So you take the coffee and you feel stimulated. It feels good. You feel up. You can concentrate. But then the more you take it, the more you kind of feel crappy afterwards. With fruit, it's stimulating your energy, your inner energy, because it's giving you the vitamins that you need for your own stimulation to happen inside your body. So it's the juice that turns on your own inner prana that is the stimulant that you look for in coffee, that you don't need the coffee anymore. Like, because your body will naturally produce stimulants. It'll press adrenaline. You'll get hyped up. But if you're fatiguing your adrenals by using coffee, then, like, over time, then the only way you're going to get hype is from that coffee. And a juice won't even – you won't even fill it off a juice. You won't even fill it off espresso. You know, like, I used to be a double Americano, you know, dude, and back in the day. And I remember I got to the point where if I didn't have that double Americano, like – I literally couldn't do anything. My body didn't make that happen on its own anymore. And that's when you know you need to just cleanse it and activate everything is when that, when you catch yourself in that situation, that's when you know, with whatever food, that's when you know, or substance, that's when you know you need to activate and cleanse.
I also just wanted to say, back to the stomach thing you were talking about with eating fruit. I know that was a question I had asked you at some point, and you had said that, and I thought, wow, that's interesting, because I was actually, I don't think I had started the 40-day activation at that point, but I was ready to not eat so much fruit. Mm-hmm. And hearing you say, actually, that's your body cleansing, mm-hmm. really gave me the faith. And now I only experience that very rarely. It's just been, gosh, a little over 20 days. Right. I still have it sometimes, seemingly random.
Me
but,
too.
Okay.
Like with fruit, I'll seemingly feel a little upset in my stomach. And I know that's like, I know it is three factors always. One, it's my body cleansing. Two, I didn't chew it enough. Like, because I eat fast. And sometimes I mush down bananas so fast. And, like, I don't get stomach aches most of the time. But every once in a while, like, if you mush down too much banana without chewing it, like, massive stomach ache. So that still happens to me. You know, I forget to chew all the time. I want to eat my food fast. And three, it's not all the way ripe. Like, you know, like, okay, well, I'm hungry and all I have is bananas. And so... And they're not right, but, you know, this one's will be fine, and you eat them, and they taste fine, and they're not going to kill you. It's better than eating fast food, but might get a stomach ache, you know?
Yeah. And another thing I found with eating this diet, with mm-hmm. eating pretty much, I mean, mostly raw foods, but in the 40-day activation, you do give people one macrobiotic meal, which is like a whole grain yep. with cooked vegetables, if they like,
yeah.
Per day.
Which I, by the way, I do almost every day.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. A lot of people think that I'm 100% raw, which I'm not.
Uh-huh.
You know, like I'm probably 90% of my calories are raw,
mm-hmm.
but I don't consider myself anything. I consider myself just a person that eats the food that's no doubt, you know. I don't have a problem with any type of food. You know, like I enjoy eating everything. And I allow myself to do that once in a while, but... I just had to throw that in there.
Yeah, I totally am right there with you. Mm-hmm. I totally am right there with you. But I just wanted to say that what I noticed pretty much right away was mm-hmm. I just was really strong.
Yeah.
I couldn't believe that I could like hold myself in these weird positions that I know that I couldn't have held myself in before. And mm-hmm. I was so impressed with mm-hmm. just how strong I got. It was like my muscles were – that to me I think was – the biggest confirmation
yeah.
with this diet was like, I was strong. I've always right. been really thin right. and that's great.
Yeah.
And I probably always will be.
Yeah.
But I never got really strong and yeah. I just was like, holy mackerel, right. like I'm gaining weight. Like that's big for me.
Right. Like not stroking my ego, but this diet has to like keep up with me.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Yeah. And I'm aggro, man, dude. I'm an hour and a half plus of yoga every day.
Wow.
I ride my bike every day.
Wow.
I do pull-ups and push-ups and leg-ups and crazy stuff with rad ex-cons by the lake 4 or 5 times a week. I dance 3 to 5 times a week. You know what I mean? It's like I burn a lot of calories, and I need to be strong. You know what I mean?
Mm.
And this food and the meditations and the mindset that go into the 40-day activation – that's what they're all about. They're about like making it so that you can be really powerful and empowered with your choices, you know what I mean? And happiness. I want to give people the skills to pick how to be happy. You know what I mean? It's like shit comes up. Stuff comes up and you don't have control over it. But you have control yeah. over your inner world and your choices and the way you respond to things. And I'm just trying to shine a little light on like what could be for people.
And I love that you include meditation, which I mean yeah. is such a natural part of being a holistic being, right?
Right.
That was another part of your program that really grabbed me then was that, you know, meditation, whether it's visualization,
right.
you give a lot of examples of different meditations, which was wonderful.
Yeah.
That's been also a really great thing for me. So
awesome. Yeah, it's a complete package really. If you remove one of If you remove the diet, it doesn't work. If you remove the meditation, it won't work. If you remove the physical play and the activity, it won't work. Like it's, again, I've taken a synthesis of the things that are no doubters. Like Western science, world science, and history has all proven that the way to get clear, calm, and to activate your prefrontal lobe, which is creativity, love, yeah, compassion, all the rad stuff, is to meditate. That's a no doubter. There is nothing that anyone can say that will take that away. It's truth. So that's in the program. Physical activity. I mean, that, I don't even have to go into that. Duh. You have to move your body, or it's gonna die. So that one is a no brainer. But the meditation philosophy behind this is that it doesn't have to really be the standard sit and just nothing. You know what I mean? I try to give some real options so that with the mind that is today, you can still meditate. And I'm a big fan of mind sculpting. I mind sculpt all the time, and literally I mind sculpt something Thursday, it manifests next Friday. I mind sculpt something last year, and it's falling in my lap right now.
Is that the same just as like visualizing or feeling the feelings around what you'd like to create?
Mind sculpting it takes that into account. That's a big part of it, but there's little steps that are the most important that you have to dive into. So first is you have to get into a meditative state, however you want to do that, walking, jogging, laying down, sitting up perfectly like the Buddha. For me, it's sitting down, breathing, just mellowing out. And then once I get into a place where I feel relaxed, I can feel my heart rate just chill, and I'm just able to sit comfortably, I find what's called as a gap. It's like a little spot where I connect. You know, there's like these little weird things that happen within meditation if you just sit long enough that they'll happen, where you feel like, whoa, I felt different right there. Or, whoa, I didn't have any thoughts for like 2 seconds. Or like, whoa, I just went like 15 seconds or 20 seconds or a minute and didn't judge any thoughts. They just were happening. And I could like, I felt my true self. I felt like, oh, wait, I'm the being, the entity that hears the thoughts, that hears the voices that are all talking. When I'm talking to myself, like, I'm really just listening to two voices talking. You know what I mean? It's like you experience that, and then you bring into your mind exactly what you want, like so much that you can feel it. Meaning, like, if I want to be an airline pilot, that's like, I feel that in my soul. Like, I want to be an airline pilot. So what I'd do is I'd start to meditate. I'd find the gap, and then I'd bring into myself tying my laces to my shoes, my airline pilot shoes, pulling those black socks up, putting those trousers on that are perfectly pressed, and like feeling the warmth of the trousers, buckling them my belt and hearing the like bringing as much experience into the meditation as you can. Once you're feeling anything, it's in your subconscious and it's in the vortex. It's out of the world. Once you feel something in your meditation, it's into the subconscious and in the world. Then all you have to do, this is the hardest part, the very, very hardest part, is let it go. Forget about it. Because if you think about it, your ego will come in and it will sabotage everything. The amount that you can feel something and then let it go is the quickness in which it will come to you.
I like that.
And it really, really happens.
I like that.
I dare you to try to make that a wrong statement.
Okay. Dare accepted.
Yeah. To the world. Like, try to make that, like, try to prove me wrong and watch what happens.
I like that. You know, in my meditation, I do something similar, but the letting go part, I'm going to add that.
I think that's real. I really believe that's the key, because that puts it into the knowledge that, wait a second, I have everything that I really need, and all I have to do is like let it come to me. The world, the oneness, tapping into that and letting that take care of the details is what we can't do as humans. We're creators. We're manifestors.
Yeah.
And then we're also enjoyers. And the world takes care of the details. And that's like why our society is so backwards, is because like all the people making all the money are the detailers, are the people that are pushing things left and right and doing the job of what the world already does. And it's not needed. Like, we just need more dreamers, more manifestors, more creators, and let the world handle it. That's just what I think anyway.
I think that sounds great. Sounds like a new planet.
Yeah.
So I really love, again, that your program is so holistic.
Yeah.
Thank you. Because for me, my personal mission with my own health is that when I'm in a complete place of physical unity, I feel then I can do here in the physical world what my soul has been wanting to do. It's like my body can finally go there because it feels so good.
Totally.
That it can, I can manifest all those dreams. I can do everything that I want to do. And it seems to me that, like, that's kind of what the 40-day activation is about. It's like about activating that, getting you healthy, getting you mm-hmm. still,
yeah.
you know, getting it's you truly, in your spirit.
It's that's, I mean, that's exactly what it is. And there's so many different ways to say, like, being activated or being transformed or being whatever you want to call it. And like what you were saying, like when you're at your physical best and when you're mentally clear and feeling calm, it feels like you can create what you want to create. It gives you the power and gives you the energy to take what's in your mind and not be distracted and really go forth with it. Another thing that people tell me all the time is like, you know, I used to drink coffee or drink alcohol or smoke weed or take drugs to feel like get downloads and like heighten my mind and like and like give me a glimpse of what life could be. And then once they kind of like learn the lessons from that and clean up and go the absolute ultra clean route, they juice and they're like, dude, I get so high from the juice. It's like way better than smoking weed. Like the downloads I get from my carrot ginger blaster is like the dankest chronic I've ever smoked. And it's like, it's true. It's like, for me, that's kind of what it is. Like I like to have fun and like, it feels really good. Like being at a really high level of being alkalized, cleansed, filled with vitamins, filled with minerals. Like I have 100% of all my body's minerals and vitamins are taken care of, and it's 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
Right.
It happened for me at 6:30 this morning, you know what I mean? Mm. After I drank my juice.
Yeah.
And it's like, and that's really what it's all about. It's about activating yourself to the point where you can like let your manifestations and let the things you really want to do in life happen and lets you be able to let them happen. And the bigger part of 40-day activation is I want to be having sex when I'm 80.
Yes.
And I want to look good yes. while I'm having sex when I'm 80. And I want my partner to look good and for me to be making love to her when she's 80 or whoever your partner is. And it's like, that's a huge part of it for me. And people will laugh at that, but it's truly true. At 80, I'm going to be alive because a lot of us will be. And I want to have fun. I don't want to be decrepit. I don't want to be, you know, bedridden. I want to still be able to dance and like ride my bike and like enjoy life. And with this lifestyle of meditating, having fun, drinking the juices, getting all the nutrients, it happens. You know, there's proof. There's actual people that have lived this way long enough now that are elders, and you can see it in them. And it's like, that's what I really want.
And that's what I like about your program is that it's such a wonderful introduction for people.
Mm-hmm.
It gives them all the basics, I guess you could say,
yeah.
that a lot of us health enthusiasts might know, but it really gives people the basics
right.
and to really get them activated. And then maybe at the end of their 40 days, they think, do I want to continue this? More than likely.
Or even like people yeah. that have taken it and gone 4 days
uh-huh.
and quit. Like every single person that starts gains one thing. Like
yeah.
One of the people that started 40-day activation quit after 4 days.
Mm.
This little group we just started, and she quit after 4 days. And she just emailed me like, I think like 2 days ago, and she was like, "I'm still juicing." She's like, "I'm juicing,
whoa.
And I've noticed that it's replaced one of my bad meals almost every day." She's like, "I love the juice; it's so good." And so it's like, that's what it's all about. She got activated. She got activated in 4 days.
Four days.
She really got her money's worth.
Four days.
Yeah, 4 day activation for her.
4 day activation.
You know, is she ultra healthy? No, but is she way healthier than she was 4 days before that? Yeah, and it's a new habit for her. So that's also what it's hugely about for me is like any form of activation. Like people get, "Oh, I only made it 12 days. Like, man, that sucks. Like, I'm sorry." I'm like, "No, dude, look,
yeah.
you're not drinking coffee anymore. It's all good. Like, pick up from there and keep trying, you know? This didn't happen for me overnight. You know what I mean? I've been on this journey for 10 years.
So I want to ask you a question.
Yeah.
What would you like to say to people mm-hmm. who are interested in your program?
Yeah.
And who have very deep, chronic health conditions like obesity or diabetes or something that maybe is not, you know, just like the average American who wants to be healthy, someone who's really, really sick and wants to get better.
I would say to them, man, it's actually for them, it's the easiest, you know what I mean? Because it happens so fast, you know what I mean? First off, I'll say go and consult with your doctor, bring this diet plan to your doctor and have him approve it, because I'm not a doctor, nor would I ever want to be. I practice health, and there's a big difference between medicine and health. I want that to be known. That's part of my big plan as an educator, is to see, let society know the difference between what health is and what medicine is. You go to a doctor and they're going to, not all doctors are bad. All doctors are great. All doctors want to help people. So I'm not, this is no anti-doctor thing, but medicine is different from health. First, I just had to get that out. Someone with chronic disorders, consult your doctor, show them the plan. And then I would say, take it really, 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 really slow and be really, really, really patient. Maybe try to do 40-day activation like one day, and then the next day, you know, or just take one part of the 40-day activation.
Yeah, like juicing
like,
or something.
Like here's the number one thing anyone can do for their health is the first thing you do in the morning is have hot water and lemon. That's the best thing that everyone can do for their health. That's even people that are fruitarians.
Yeah, like, I do that.
Yeah, exactly. It's like such a little thing, but I could go deep into the science of that, but I don't feel like it. So for someone with like chronic disorder, pick one piece of it and do it. Either the macrobiotic meal every day.
Yeah, that even just that alone.
3 ounces of juice.
Great.
I would say the best thing is take at least 20 ounces of vegetable juice per day in place of a meal. For most people in a week, they'll actually see huge test result differences just from that. Because one, they'll get all the minerals they need. Two, they'll start to become more alkalized. Three, they'll cut down on their fat intake. And four, their body will start to poop.
Yes, that's another thing I noticed about juicing. And I've noticed this before, like when I would do kombucha fasts and all this stuff but I noticed it even more pronounced with juicing is like I have my juice in the morning. So, okay, wake up. Okay, I'm going to get real personal here. Mm-hmm. So I wake up, drink my hot water with lemon, have to go number two, do that. Great. Come and have my juice, drink some water shortly thereafter, like, you know, maybe an hour after I drink my juice. Then I have to go number two again. And it's like a full load.
Like 5-6
every
times
day.
A day is normal for people that are cleansing. On this type of cleanse, like honestly, this is another question I get a lot from people that are a little bit afraid of the fruit, because they're like, well, every time I eat fruit, then I have to go to the bathroom.
That's a good thing.
I'm like, yes.
Yeah. We like that.
And then they go, well, my doctor told me that my poop is supposed to be like slightly firm and nice big long logs. And I'm like, why? Doesn't that hurt? Do you have to push to get that out? It's like, yeah. And then I said, okay, well, let me just break this down to you. Digestion is the hardest thing the body does. The hardest thing the body does in the world. Not lifting weights, not running a marathon. Nothing is harder on the body than digesting.
Yeah, really?
It's the hardest thing on the nervous system.
Wow.
It's the hardest thing. So if you're putting the hardest food to digest in your system, you're wearing yourself out. You're pre-aging yourself out. All your energy is going into digestion. That's the thing with the fruits and the vegetables. There is no digestion. It's boom. And that's the way the poop comes out, like fish food. And that's what you want. So it's like, would you rather just sit on the toilet, not push and be done, and then wipe and get off and go? Literally a minute.
A minute. Yep.
Sit
a minute.
And push and give yourself hernia and give yourself prostate cancer and release cortisol while you should be having a peaceful release. You know what I mean? Like pooping should be one of my mentors is, it should be a peaceful release. Like, oh, there's a buildup. You go sit down. Oh, I feel better. Now I can go eat.
Yeah.
Like, instead of like, oh my, you know, pushing. So that's another fruit and veg fact is that, yeah, you will poop a lot. That's good.
So while we're on the topic of pooping, so I was on this 40-day activation, lots of fruit and everything. And then I get taken out to a movie, and it's like a movie I really want to see. And what do they buy? They buy a bunch of crappy GMO movie popcorn, and I'm resisting. And then me, like so many of us, was like, you know what? I'm just going to have a little bit. And then a little bit becomes, oh, I ate half the bag. And anyways, I woke up the next morning, and I was literally sick. Mm-hmm. I was literally sick in my intestines. Yeah. And the crazy thing is, and that's all I did different. I had like a little half a bag of movie popcorn,
right.
And I couldn't go number two in the morning.
Yeah.
And it was so bizarre to me to have that feeling of not being able to go mm-hmm. because of something I ate that made me sick. And it's like, wow, it just made me realize that so many people just live that way. They don't even know any better.
We don't even realize how desensitized our bodies have become and so built up on that stuff. Like when that becomes normal to your body, when you do take like not being able to poop as that's normal, I'll take Pepto-Bismol or I'll take a laxative or whatever. Or if you're someone that has grenade belly, you know, like because you have a fast metabolism and you're highly acidic and you have acid reflex and, you know, irritable bowel syndrome. It's like that stuff is really, there's like such an easy out to all that. You don't need to take any drugs. You don't need to really do anything except just eat fruit and eat vegetables. That's it. It's so simple.
And that's another thing that I love about your program is that it's so simple. It's like, yes, I have to clean my juicer each morning.
Yeah.
But overall, I don't have to make oatmeal and watch it boil and then clean the pot and or make my lunch ahead of time. I just grab some bananas, dates, and a little bit of greens, and I'm done. And I have so much more time. I realize I wasted so much time creating food or going out to eat food. And, you know, that's obviously another thing is don't go out to eat as often. Or when I do, I just get a big salad. But I feel so much better that it's worth it. It's like I tried a piece of cake the other day. It was so foreign in my body.
Totally. I know that. Like I've tried Taco Bell.
Oh.
You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
I tried Taco Bell like 2.5 weeks ago. Like a, just a bean and cheese burrito, like a bite of it. And I couldn't swallow.
You couldn't swallow.
It was literally like my body would not.
It wouldn't let you swallow it.
It was like,
don't eat that.
Yeah, it's like, no, you're not.
we're not going to do that.
So I basically spit it out and was just like, you know, wow, that's really crazy. Cause I hadn't had that experience in my life. Like still I up until now, maybe a year and a half ago, I could still just like take a Big Mac and just destroy it and be totally fine. Cause my metabolism is pretty crazy. Like food has never been the issue. Like I never knew it was the issue, you know?
Yeah.
Cause I didn't gain weight, you know, mm-hmm. so I'm fine. And I had regular bowel movement, so I'm fine. And, you know, and I don't get chubby when I eat tons of fast food. So I was like, oh, I'm healthy, you know? But then little by little, you know, I hit 24 and I had skin disorders that doctors didn't even know what the heck it was, really. You know what I mean? I had like one doctor would say, oh, you might have psoriasis. And another one would say, oh, it's rosacea. And then say, oh, it looks like you might have an immune disorder. And the next one would, everyone said different things, but they all gave me drugs. They all gave me creams.
Yeah. Which is what they're trained to do.
Right. Which, you know, okay, that's what I went to people that are again, they practice medicine.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Which they do a great job. But
with that.
Right. Exactly. And I like, I think that you should attack it from all angles, really. Mm-hmm. Like get the medicine, use it short term, but also try to do it naturally and combine them both and see how powerful that is. Or just do it all natural so you have no side effects. That's the no doubter.
Yeah, that's the great thing about your program is it really activates the body. The body is designed to heal and rejuvenate itself when it has everything it needs. That's what it does.
Yeah, it's what it naturally does. Like in every 40 days, you're basically the 40 day has a lot of kind of backstory to it. But another thing about 40 days is almost every 40 days, you're a whole new cellular being. All your cells have
regenerated that.
And like the skin you're looking at right now in 40 days is going to be all new cells.
Wow. You know
what I mean? So it's like, okay, you have a choice. Like at the end of 40 days, you can fill like your body up with, and your mind and your emotions up with stuff that will, and that's what your cells are. It's mind, body, emotion. We know that. That's science. Like Western generic Christian-based Western science even has to now be like, okay, right, there is a mind-body-soul connection in every cell. So that's established. what you put into that 40 days later is going to be the outcome. Shoot, you have a lot of choice in what you're looking like and what your life is like.
Mm.
Lots of choice.
Yeah, and isn't that what it just boils down to? It's like you really have the choice mm-hmm. to create your health and your right. life and anything mm-hmm. in your life, really. And it's really up to you. Mm-hmm. It's not up to your mom or what you learned from your parents. It's like right. it's up to you right in here, right now right. to make that change.
Exactly. It's an ultra minimal, simple way of looking at life. Like it doesn't matter what your conditioning is. It doesn't mm-hmm. matter your story. It doesn't matter... like what happened to you when you're five, like all those things matter, like, you know, but all that really matters is that like right now you have a choice, and the choice can be invigorated by like what you want to manifest and what you love, and with health and from a clear standpoint, or it can be kind of like muddled and gray and kind of dull and just not as vibrant and fun.
In the past, when I acquire some new health knowledge, I'll beat myself up, or I'll make myself wrong or guilty. Like, oh, my body was feeling that intuitively. Why haven't I been mm-hmm. doing this? Mm-hmm. Like,
yeah,
you know,
that's a huge part of it, and a huge part of my practice in general is like, I don't call anything right or wrong.
Yes,
like nothing
absolutely.
Is like nothing is right Me or too. Wrong. It's just all about like, if I do this, then what are the results? You know what yeah. I mean? So if like I do this behavior, then I'm going to feel this way. So then you just can just pick, well, then I'll pick this behavior because I want to feel like that. It's the same with eating. It's the same with meditating. It's the same with yoga and or physical activity. It's like, you know, you have the choice. You can make the decisions.
Yeah.
It's not like meat is bad and that you shouldn't do it and that it's horrible or the processed food is horrible. It's that... Okay, if you know you, the facts are that if you eat it, then the possibility of getting disease and cancer is there. You will enjoy it. That's a fact, or else you wouldn't be eating it. And then another fact is that fruits, vegetables, meditation, having fun, dancing, being surrounded by loving people, create long-term health and happiness. And it's like, you can choose, like, you know, which one you want. And you can sometimes choose a little bit of this and then go back to this. That's what most humans do, right?
Yeah, yeah.
You know, we like to dabble in the dark side and right. get our yum on and then jump back onto the high vibrational. And it's like, what balance and, like, what things do you want to pull from in what area? For me, the food is just, I don't even, it's like, that's above all everything. Because if I'm eating really, really tight, then kind of everything else falls into place for me.
Isn't that the truth?
Yeah.
Isn't that the
I've
truth?
I've tried it other ways too. I've tried yep. to make meditation the main. I've tried to make the working out the main focus. But if I just yeah. keep eating, like consistently keep eating correctly more and more, like my athletic ability keeps getting way better without trying. I keep getting way stronger without trying. I keep getting way leaner and way buffer without as much effort. My yoga, I keep getting way more flexible, and I only do 15 minutes of yoga practice a day. I used to do 2 hours every day, like
wow.
really, 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 really hard asana practice, and I was getting not that flexible because uh-huh. I was still having a lot of acidity in my body. Now I'm
yeah.
constantly alkalizing, so
oh.
the little stretching I do opens me up like three times as much.
You know, I have noticed that because a part of the routine is morning yoga, which, by the way, I loved. And I love the sequence, even though it's so simple. And mm-hmm. Maybe I've done it before, but I love that sequence in the morning. Like, cool. It just feels so yeah. right. After I'm done, I have to do my savasana, my mm-hmm. 5 minutes of just lying.
Mm-hmm.
I can't do anything else. I'm so primed for that.
Mm-hmm.
And I actually do it at night now, too. It's such a wonderful way to start being in my body,
mm-hmm.
start being in my body before I eat or before I drink my juice.
Yeah. It's that all came about, the knowledge in my body that derived from, I was like 20, I don't know. It was a long time ago. And I had stopped, I was taking Adderall. I was in
oh, wow.
getting like a double bachelor's degree or something. And I was using Adderall to like help me study. And it was like causing all these health problems. And I was like, what? I didn't know. Like, none of the doctors said, stop taking Adderall. Side story. And, like, I was using that, and I'd take it in the morning, then go to work. And then by noon, I'd be like, oh, I need more Adderall, you know, dude. So I'd take more Adderall, and get through my workday and get through my studying. And it was killing me.
Mm.
I stopped doing that and was like, tried some coffee, you know, the coffee didn't, it's not like Adderall. I started doing sun salutations, like at 6 a.m. before anything else. I would do just literally 10 minutes of sun salutations, which is just a yogic flow that kind of wakes your body up slowly with the sun. I would be on such a high blast from that because it was causing me to stretch my body out, open up my spine, but more than that, it was causing me to connect to my breath, which took control of my emotions, which took control of my mindset, which then took control of everything. Because your whole life is your relationships to your thoughts. That's the whole game, is what you eat and your relationship to your thoughts. And so that sun salutation that would last me all day, and the effects were greater than the Adderall, meaning my ability to focus, my ability to be social, and my ability to just like stay alert and be ready to do stuff. Like, boom. And I was like, from 15 minutes of sun salutations. And I tested it too. I'd have days when I wouldn't do it, and I'd be a mess.
I've noticed the same thing. There are some days where I feel like I'm rushed in the morning and I've got to go somewhere and I'm like, oh, I don't have time for my sauna. And I don't do it. It's like I didn't have breakfast or something. It's not even, oh, I forgot to brush my teeth. It's not like that. It's more like something's really wrong. My day stops flowing. Medicine. Yeah.
All this stuff in 40-day activation is given really simple names, and it's put in the most layman terms as possible, but every piece of it's crazy powerful medicine.
So where can people find out more information? I know there's a lot of different places, but
right. The two best places to find information out about what I'm doing is on rudayoga.com, which is RUDDHA.com. That has my whole background of yogic side, my story, what I do with yoga therapy. There's no 40-day activation stuff on that. There's not much about nutrition. It's mostly yoga. But that can give people a nice background. It's got a good bio on it. For more current stuff, you can go to YouTube channel 40 Day Activation. You can visit both Facebook pages, 40 Day Activation group, and my 40 Day Activation business page, which I think I launched both of those about 20-something days ago. So, you know, you can find information out on my Facebook or like me if you do or if you don't. It's all good, too. And there will be 40dayactivation.com in probably mid-August. So stay tuned for that.
We'll look forward to that. So, but until then, if you just go to YouTube and type in 40-day activation, or you go into Facebook in the search bar, type in 40-day activation, that's how they can how they can find you right now.
And to book me, it's all on Ruta Yoga, like for private sessions, for you know, to start a dialogue about 40-day activation for yourself. All the information's on there.
Lastly, Rob, what is one thing that you'd like to say to everyone?
I'd like to share that I think above everything else that we've talked about, and I think I've said that about a million times today, like the most important thing or above everything else, but this is truly the bottom line philosophy, is if you can listen, if you can quiet yourself enough to listen to what you need and base your life on that rather than what you want in your brain, you'll be surprised at what magic can happen. I'll just leave it at that.
Master of the 40-day activation himself. Oh, gosh, Rob. Well, thank you so much for being here and sharing your wisdom and your knowledge. And thank you to you for tuning in and listening to our show today. Please check out our next episode of Realms of Healing. We will be having on a very special guest, Padma Maxwell, and she's going to be sharing with you some incredibly profound and simple secrets to market your own spiritual or metaphysical brand that you want to promote. So it's going to be a business show. Alrighty, love you, blessings, and remember, it's all perfect.
Realms Radio, where spirit rocks. Would you like to receive empowerment, help, and healing from heaven and the angelic realms? Schedule your one-on-one intuitive reading with me, Tana Newberry, the Angel Gal, and hear from all of your heavenly helpers and loved ones in spirit. Whether you're seeking guidance about your career, your love life, your life purpose, or anything else that can bring you more peace and more joy, I am happy to help. Learn more about my services and how to receive a free consultation at my website, www.theangelgal.com, right here on Realms Radio.